Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to solve this second order ODE in MATLAB using Simulink toolbox. In the previous tutorials, we discussed how to solve differential equations using ODE45 or dsolve commands. You can check those tutorials, but using Simulink is ridiculously easy, so watch this tutorial until the end. To start Simulink, click here. If you don't see this button, just type Simulink in the command window. It may take a few minutes to show up, then click on blank model. I want to solve this equation. It resembles a mass spring damper mechanism. Let's talk about the method of solving this ODE in Simulink. Suppose I rearrange the equation like this. Then if I integrate both sides of the equation with respect to t, the left hand side is going to be x prime. Now if I integrate it again, the left-hand side will be x. Our aim was to find x, so if only I could simplify the right-hand side, I would have the answer. But since this expression depends on x, it is impossible for us to integrate it, but Simulink can. So we only need to define this expression in Simulink and integrate it twice. If you click on this button, a window pops up which contains every tool in Simulink. There are a lot of tools, and at first it might seem overwhelming. Each of these tools need a separate tutorial to explain, but for now we only focus on a few of them. I want to define this expression as a function, so I search for function and press enter. I scroll down and see MATLAB function. I could have also found this tool right here under user defined functions. I drag and drop it here. Then I need to integrate it twice. So I search integrator. If I click on it, MATLAB tells me where it is located. It is under commonly used blocks. Yes, it is here. It is also under continuous section. So there are multiple ways to find each tool. Again, I drag and drop it into my model. Not once, but twice. I also want to plot the result, so I need a tool named scope. To define this expression as a function, you can see that we need x prime and x. If I double click on it, it goes to MATLAB editor, where we can define it. By default, this function has a name, one input and one output argument. I call the output argument x double prime. I don't change the function name, and the input arguments are going to be x and x prime. Then I define this relation and save it. It asks me to save the Simulink model. I hit OK. Here I can see it. Now I go back to Simulink. If I make this box a little bigger, I can see that the input and output terminals have new names. The output signal here is x double prime. I drag it to the input terminal of my first integrator. Now the output signal here is going to be x prime. Then I integrate it again and I'll have x. Then x can be plotted in the scope tool. Next, I have to connect x prime and x signals to their corresponding terminals here. To do that, just right-click and hold this signal until it reaches the terminal. I repeat it for X. Now I have to set the time span and initial conditions. Time starts from 0 and by default, Simulink solves it for 10 seconds. I want 15. Then to set the initial conditions, I double-click on each integrator. At the beginning of time, X prime is 0 and X is 1. I run the model. and when it is ready, I double click on the scope to see the result. The result is not smooth. Is it correct? To check if the solution is correct, I add a tool named SimOut. This tool sends a variable to MATLAB workspace. I want to check if X is a correct solution. So I send its signal to workspace. I double click on it and change the save format to array. And run the model again. Then I go to MATLAB and see the variables are imported. In a new editor, I solve the equation using ODE45. I want to compare the results. Now T and X are the solutions of MATLAB ODE, and TOUT and SimOut are the solutions of Simulink. I plot both of them in a graph. You see the results match perfectly. If you want a smoother result from Simulink, one way is to increase the precision of result or change the step size. Click on this gear icon. You can see the settings for a start and end time. You can set the step to whatever you like. If you want a fixed step size, choose it. I run the model and see that the result is still not smooth. Here, MATLAB tells me the fixed step size is 0.3. I set it to 0.03. Now the result is much smoother. Or you can have a variable step size, but increase the accuracy. I reduce the error tolerance to 1e-6. Again, the result is smooth. Simulink has lots of other options and it is a very powerful tool for engineers. If you want me to create more tutorials about it, let me know in the comments. Please subscribe to my channel and bye bye.